Listen up, kids. If you're 12 years old and you haven't fought for your country yet, you need to step your game up because you are a freaking loser. We're fast-tracking through the ranks, says John Klim on today's Motivated Moments in History. John Klim was born in Ohio in August 1851. When he was 11, his mother was killed in a train accident. You know, but instead of playing Pokemon and trying to avoid cooties, he ran away and enlisted in the Union Army. He first attempted to enlist in the Ohio Infantry, but was rejected to him being, you know, like 11. Well, determined, he ran his ass up to Michigan and tried to enlist in the 22nd Michigan Infantry. Once again, he was denied, but he refused to leave and soon became a volunteer drummer and somewhat of a mascot for the regiment. So at 11 years old and dropped out of school because reading, writing, and arithmetic are for nerds, he picked up his drumsticks and went on to slay some motherfucking ponies. The troops in his company soon pitched together to pay his $13 a month salary, and they got him a uniform and even sawed down a musket so he could use it. That's right. At 11, this kid had an official uniform and a sawed-off musket. When I was 11, I was worried about collecting baseball cards and stacking Legos. This kid was collecting sawed-off muskets and stacking bodies. Damn it, I am a loser! During the Battle of Chickamauga, he rode an artillery case onto the front and got off and started peeling some cats back. The Union was getting dealt with rather severely, so they started to retreat. Well, John, during the retreat, he was halted by a Confederate Colonel Calvin Walker, who demanded his surrender. Well, John wasn't down for ending his super realistic game of backyard laser tag, so he said, "Eat my shorts, man," and pulled his trigger, and cowabunga that dude all over his stupid face. The colonel didn't die, but he was significantly wounded. When John finished his retreat and rejoined his company, he was promoted to sergeant at 12. 12! Right now, there are 16-year-old dorks who think they're the hot shiznit because they're a cadet corporal in their podunk high school JROTC drill team. This dude was 12 and already stacking gray coats with the legitimate UCMJ authority to make a 30-year-old grown-ass man go in shit-burning detail. And he went on to fight in a few more battles as he moved down south and was eventually captured in October 1863 in Georgia. There he was used as anti-Union propaganda, but was released later on in a prisoner swap. Well, he went on to finish the war and sustained two injuries. He was discharged in 1864. He went back to school and graduated in 1870 and re-entered the Army in 1871. He was given an appointment to West Point by Ulysses S. Grant, but failed the entrance exam multiple times. But it was for good reason because, you know, instead of like swinging on the playground and learning about prepositional phrases and dumbass math problems, he was racking up kill points for the good old US of A. So unable to get into West Point, Ulysses still commissioned him as a second lieutenant in the Eternal Fraternity of Blessed Butter and Pain, also known as the King of Motherfucking Battle. But soon after attending artillery school, he transferred over to the Lords of Logistics, known as United States Quartermaster. I try to make it sound badass. It's not working. He stayed in the Army until he was 64 and retired at the rank of Brigadier General. Congress soon approved a post-service promotion to Major General soon after his retirement. Somewhere in all this, he got married twice and had a bunch of kids. He died in 1937 and is buried at Arlington. And that, kids, is your Motivated Moments in History!